Welcome back to another Quick Tip Tuesday. And today I'm gonna be throwing out two tips that is going to make your audio better instantly. A bunch of you have asked me to watch your videos recently, give you my opinion on things, and there's one thing that I keep seeing over and over and over again, and we're gonna fix that today. And these Quick Tip Tuesdays are now brought to you by Epidemic Sound. They are my personal choice in YouTube music licensing and the soundtrack of every video on this channel. If you guys want a 1 month free trial to Epidemic Sound, the first link in the description. Check it out, download some music for free. Make your videos better with better music. That should be their whole tagline. Okay, today we are gonna be talking about audio and specifically two tips to fix the number one mistake that I see in your videos having to do with audio. And I know that a lot of you are here from my GoPro videos, but stay with me because this totally applies to GoPro as well. Larger cameras, GoPros, smaller cameras, anything where you're using an external microphone, this applies. And if you're not using an external microphone, that's the first tip. That's before this tip. Get an external microphone. In all the videos that I've been watching lately, I see a very familiar vlogging setup, something like a GorillaPod with a camera on top, with a Rode VideoMic Pro or some other microphone on top of that, and they're walking around like this, or a GoPro setup, like GoPro with a Rode VideoMic on top, and people are vlogging like this, and it sounds pretty decent, actually. It sounds good. But then people set up the camera like this. They sit down in front of it, they want to talk to camera, and suddenly the audio sounds terrible. And the mistake here is that you leave the microphone on top of the camera. See, with microphones in general, the goal is to get the microphone as close to your mouth as possible. Like when Morgan is in studio recording one of her albums, they have the microphone like this, a pop filter in front of that, and then she's like mouth on it. Singing. You might not want your microphone that close, but you get the idea. The closer, the better. So leaving your microphone on top of your camera, 3, 4, 5 feet away from you, drastically reduces the audio quality that you're gonna get from that microphone. So in this setup here that I have with you guys, I have a Rode VideoMic Pro just out of frame on a C stand. Let me show you real quick. All right, now you can see it. So this is a Rode VideoMic Pro. This is a C stand that booms over and the stand sits next to my table. But with this setup, it puts the microphone when I'm right here talking to you guys about 9 inches away from my mouth. 9 inches is perfect. I heard it. But the idea here is that the microphone is really close to my mouth. How I normally have the shot set up, it is just out of frame, but really close to my mouth still. Whereas the camera right now is... You guys are... 4.5 feet from my mouth. So I took the microphone and I had it on top of my camera. I'm just gonna move the C-stand, but I'll put the microphone directly above the camera right now. Okay, so the microphone is directly above the camera. I'll adjust the levels so that the levels stay the same, but this is the difference in, yeah, 4.5 feet away from my mouth versus 9 inches away from my mouth. It's totally different. You can hear the room more. You can hear the echo of the room. My voice is no longer the main thing that it's picking up. It's hearing my voice, but it's also hearing it reverb around the room. Now, ideally, I would have this room audio treated with blankets or sound panels, but even not having those, just having the microphone close to my mouth makes it sound way better. Hang on. I am back to the 8 or 9 inches from my mouth and the microphone sounds way better. The audio sounds cleaner. And if I zoom this back in, boom, I have clean audio. The microphone is just out of frame so my viewer can't see it and I get really good results, even in a room that has no audio treatment. I'm actually in a garage with a concrete floor, hard walls. There is no audio treatment in here at all. And it still sounds pretty good, totally usable because the microphone is only 8 or 9 inches away from my mouth. Now again, I'm using a C stand here. C stands are kind of expensive. There is one very cheap alternative to a C stand that this totally works for. It's right. This is one of Morgan's mic stands that she uses on stage. It is super cheap, like $25. And this does pretty much the same job. The C-stand can go way higher, I can kind of boom it out better, but in a pinch, this thing works great. Just make sure that you get one that has a 3/8 inch screw underneath the microphone bit. So you pop that off, it has a 3/8 inch screw that goes perfectly into the bottom of your Rode microphone. Okay, the first way to get the microphone close to your mouth is some sort of boom pole or mic, or just rig it, hang it from the ceiling. Whatever you do, try to keep it out of frame. Although I know a lot of people are having it in frame now, they just have the mic sitting there on the table or on a boom arm coming across. But if you're doing a documentary or an interview, something like that, with your camera, get it set up, frame your shot, and then put this just out of the frame. But the second way that you can get a microphone really close to someone's mouth is a lav mic. We talked about this in last week's quick tip. But the Rode SmartLav Plus is a super inexpensive, I think it's like 50 bucks maybe, but a super inexpensive way to lav somebody. With this thing, I can clip it on my t-shirt like this, and now the microphone is always 8 inches from my mouth. Now, you have to realize though, there's a big difference in how a lav mic picks up a scene versus how a boom pole picks up a scene. All right, we're recording. So basically a boom mic is going to pick up this zone. So if the camera is locked off like this and I walk away from the camera, it actually gets quieter. Or if I'm talking to you guys and then I turn around and I keep saying something, but then I come back to the microphone, you actually hear the difference when I was here versus when I'm here. So a boom mic gives you kind of more a feeling that the microphone is with the camera and that you hear me, but if I walk away or out of frame, it gets quiet. A lav mic is totally different. If I'm on a lav mic and I'm here, or if I turn around here and I start talking back here, or I walk out of frame over here, lav mic just keeps picking me up as if I haven't moved. And sometimes that's a benefit and you might want that. I personally prefer a boom mic because it feels more natural when you're watching it, and I walk away and it actually gets quieter, because I don't know, if someone walked away from me, it would get quieter. Or if they turned around, it would get significantly quieter because they were turned around. So for me, I do prefer a boom mic on a stand just out of frame, but a lav mic is also a really great option to get the microphone really close to your subject's mouth, and no matter what they do, it stays that 8 to 9 inches away from their mouth. There's also lots of cool ways to hide lav mics, like you can actually tape it underneath their shirt with Rode's InvisiMic little clippy thing. You stick it onto their chest. But either way, mic on a boom or mic on a lav, you are going to get significantly better audio with the microphone closer to your mouth than if you left it on your camera. Oh, one thing to mention with the Rode is there's an extension cable. I have to have, it's like a 10-foot extension cable that goes from the mic, shoots over to the C-stand, goes underneath, plug straight into the camera. And of course the same thing can work with a GoPro. Just put the GoPro over there, put this microphone on a boom, like yeah, put this just out of frame here, run an extension cable from here to your GoPro, and you have the exact same setup. Really shockingly good audio, even though you're filming on a GoPro. Okay, that is it. That is your quick tip Tuesday for the week. Get the microphone off your camera, bring it over here, get it near your mouth, either out of frame or in frame on a little stand. That's kind of cool now. A lot of people are doing it. And your audio will be better instantly. And thank you again to Epidemic Sound. If you guys want to get a free trial of Epidemic Sound, first link in the description. I'm gonna see you guys later this week, because there's for sure gonna be more videos this week.
Look, see, I'm still on the lav and you can still hear me over here.
Isn't that weird that I'm off camera, but you can still hear me like I'm on camera?